Knowledge doesn't mean simply information, that you read books and get some information. That is not knowledge. Knowledge is experiencing the reality the way it is. What is knowledge? Experiencing the reality the way it is. That is knowledge. When knowledge becomes very strongly embedded in our consciousness, then that's called wisdom. Wisdom is knowledge very well lodged in ourself. That makes you wise. And everybody has it. Everybody has it. Someone has this much, someone has this much. It's only a matter of time that life takes you from a little wisdom to more wisdom. Very good, very good. Words appear very futile. Still we use it sometimes. We need to use it. You know, you go to hospital and ask someone, how are you? You know they are not well. Still you ask them, how are you? And they say, fine. They know they are not fine. Still they say, fine. Similarly, I see you are all so happy. Still I ask you, how are you? You can see in your face there is so much happiness, radiance. Still we ask, how are you? It is just to engage on another level of communication. Wise communicate first from the heart, from the being, and then engage in the outer level of communication just to keep in touch. The ignorance rely on the outer communication, the not so wise. See, like it's like between mother and a child. Whatever child says, ow, or something, is immaterial. Because child has not even learned the language. But mother is communicating with the child from a deeper level, right? Isn't it? Even before you learned language, you started communicating with the mother. A mother started communicating with you. This is a deeper level of communication. Similarly, when you communicate with your dogs, with your cats, you are doing it from a very subtle level, deeper level. It's not language. Later on, you try put language so much into its brain. They don't require language. You say, come, they will come. You don't have to say, come. Listen, simply make any sound, they'll come. They don't relate to you with language. Similarly, the entire creation is relating to you. The trees, the breeze, all the creatures in the creation is communicating with you. There is certain communication happening on a very subtle level, deeper level. There is an old Sanskrit proverb that says, Vachyarambho vikara namadeya. Vachyarambha vikaro namadeya. Means words are distortion of truth. Already there is communication. Through words you are distorting it a little bit. I don't mean that words should not be used. It's necessary. But underneath the word, there is the feeling that need to be there. You can tell someone, I love you so much. But underneath that, there should be the feeling. Not just, oh, I love you so much, you know, on the surface level. So the wise first communicate only on the words, on the subtle, and then they also use the words just to complement that. But the unwise relies only on the external communication. Are you getting what I'm saying? Very subtle. And that is why misunderstandings crop up in life. Why there is misunderstanding? Because there is no inner connectivity, connection. Do you see what I'm saying? Yeah? You say something, some others understand it differently. So be in this world, enjoy this world, yet not get caught up, drowned in it. Keep yourself a little aloof. I'm saying keep yourself untouched by the external. Save your soul, save your mind, save your spirit, save your joy. Don't get that muddled by the events in the world. Are you getting what I'm saying? Don't let others or any events take away your freedom, take away your joy and your inner peace. This is utterly. It's a big task, it's a challenge. It's not too easy. I'm not telling you, it's very easy. Not flowery, buttery things. No. Life is not flowery, not buttery, I tell you. There's so many challenges. Life has so many challenges. But the wisdom or knowledge equips you to face the challenges. The difficulty is when you think life should not have challenges. Then challenges will appear even much bigger to you. Life has challenges, but wisdom equips you to face them